Hi, I've been working on this mesh for a while and now I'm trying to polypaint it using ZBrush Vertex Painting Tools. You have to do everything by hand, but the polypainting is excellent. You can use the mask by some masking options like the mask by smoothness. This way you can isolate edges and paint them a bit brighter, or you can use the mask by cavity in order to paint in areas that need to be a bit darker. So you can do a lot of things with the polypaint and the masking tools, but still it's not as amazing as the tools from 3D-COAT, the painting tools. Usually everybody, and me the same, I was using 3D-COAT only for retopologized mesh. So right now I'm exporting an FBX of my highpoly, and my idea this morning was how to paint, but vertex paint in 3D-COAT. And it's possible, I just never thought about it. So I import my FBX from ZBrush. It's a 10 million polygon or 10 million quads, something like this mesh. But 3D-COAT manages highpoly very well. And now you can access all the tools, all the alphas, all the great ways of painting in 3D-COAT, but not painting on UVs, painting on vertices. So I'm renaming the polypaint layer and I remove all this. I don't know why 3D-COAT seems to create always these empty layers. Keep layer 0 is the mesh. You don't want to mess this one up. Alright, so now I create a new layer and I'm gonna fill it with a basic blue color or something like this. It's just so that it's easier to see what I'm gonna do next. So let's use some of the algorithms from the 3D-COAT to calculate right now the curvature. So I put 248 for the definition. It's better. And let's calculate. It will take some time. The mesh is heavy. When your curvature is calculated, let's display it. And usually I choose modulate 2x as a blending, but you can try the other ones. The great thing about the curvature, it's going to add these nice bright areas on the edges and darker areas on the cavities. So all this that we could have done it with ZBrush, you see it's done automatically here and it looks really, really much better than something done by hand. Let's create another one now, the occlusion. The same, it takes time. So occlusion adds great darker areas everywhere where the light is not supposed to go, as you can see. So to paint your shadows, now all the objects will be already painted with shadows. It looks nice already compared to what we had just before. I'm displaying the polypaint to see how all this mixes together. And now let's add another one. It's just to show you all the things we can add that polypaint just doesn't enable us to do. In the render room of 3D-COAT, we can add lights, we can color the lights. It's very limited what you can do, but still it's great. You can define the height of each light, its position around the mesh, and so on. So now I'm creating another layer again. It's the baking tool of the light, and I choose the light from the render room. And 3D-COAT now is creating a third layer. So this one is the light. I don't know why by default it's multiply, which looks like shit. So I tried a few of the blendings. I'm not sure which one is the best, but divide seems to give a pretty good result. It's not exactly what I want, but it's okay for the tutorial. So let's put here 70% opacity. It seems to be fair enough. So now we have three automated layers. That makes the mesh look better, I think, already. But of course, you can still create one or 50 other layers and spend 2 days painting your stuff using all the great tools from 3D-COAT. So I'm just adding one more layer to show you everything. So yeah, don't use glossiness, just use the color, because of course, glossiness and bump, normal bump, you won't see that in ZBrush. So just paint with the plain colors. Okay, so I put three dots of color like this just to show you that all this will be exported as polypaint. So to export, go back in the sculpt room, export scene, and you export an FBX again. Don't use OBJ, you will have troubles with OBJ, use FBX, and save this file. Oh, once it's saved, oh yeah, ZBrush, 3D-COAT's wants to do some kind of Z-remeshing, let's say, a retopology of the mesh, don't do it, press cancel. So now you go back in ZBrush, you import the FBX you just did. And now you have the old mesh, if you remember what it looked like, all done by hand. And this one is the one that went through 3D-COAT's. So you've got shadows calculated in the polypaint, you've got this this weird light I put a bit under the mesh, and all this is polypaint. It's polypaint information coming from 3D-COAT's. I was so happy when I did that this morning. So yeah. And as you can see now, you've got the polypaint, so you can keep on painting on this stuff. Alright, so I think it's a very good way to, let's say, polypaint a mesh that's finished, when the sculpt is finished, before you do the retopology and the baking. And yeah, I think I'm gonna use this a lot for my next objects. So I hope you learned something. Cheers!